Hello everyone, this is me Devasmita Sarkar. Today we are going to talk about conservation of plants and animals. Extinction is when a species is completely wiped out from Earth. Once the last living individual of a species dies, the species is said to be extinct. Deforestation. Deforestation is the destruction of forest by cutting down trees. Deforestation leads to a habitat loss of many animals. This is a site of forest destruction, means deforestation. Causes of destruction. This deforestation can occur due to one of the following reasons: procuring land for cultivation, building houses and factories, making furniture using wood as fuel. Natural causes such as forest fire and severe drought can cause deforestation. Consequences of deforestation. Deforestation increases the temperature and pollution level on the earth. It increases the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. It also reduces the level of groundwater. Droughts. Drought is the lack of water in an area. Drought can happen due to lack of rainfall. This is a picture of a drought or drought area. Dustification. Formation of a desert by erosion of vegetation due to harsh weather is called desertification. Human activities like deforestation and improper irrigation are also responsible for desertification of terrains. Global warming. Global warming is the change of climate on a global level. Usually, average temperature increases, leading to melting of ice caps in the poles. Excessive pollution and deforestation cause global warming. Here is a picture of 2015 annual temperate local records of global warming. Species. A species is a group of individuals that can breed and successfully produce fertile offspring. Make the world a greener place. Recycling of paper. Paper industry is a leading cause of deforestation since they need wood pulp. Recycling paper can help in reducing the consumption of wood pulp by the paper industry. Reforestation. Reforestation is restocking of the destroyed forest by planting new trees. Wildlife conservation. Conservation of forest and wildlife. Due to the threat from mankind's indulgence, it is important for us to conserve the forest and its wildlife. Wildlife is important for us to maintain balance in nature. Wildlife sanctuary. A wildlife sanctuary is a naturally occurring sanctuary, such as an island, that provides protection for species from hunting, predation, competition, or poaching. National park. flora and fauna. The plant and animals found in a particular area are termed flora and fauna on that of that area respectively. National park. A national park is a park that is used for biodiversity conservation. They are developed and maintained by the union government. Biosphere reserves. Biosphere and biodiversity. The biosphere is that part of the earth in which living organisms exist or which supports life. Biological diversity or biodiversity refers to the variety of organisms existing on the earth, their interrelationships and their relationships with the environment. Here is a picture, see it. Endemic species. Endemic species are those species of plants and animals which are found exclusively in a particular area. Biosphere reserve. Biosphere reserves are the areas that are protected from human intervention. These areas help in conservation of endangered species. Protect Tiger. Protect Tiger was launched by the government to protect and conserve the dwindling tiger population in the country. Several natural parks have been associated with the Protect Tiger initiatives. Here is a picture. This is the sign of Protect Tiger. Endangered animals. Animals whose numbers are diminishing to a level. Diminishing means getting lesser. That they might face extinction are known as endangered animals. Ecosystem. An ecosystem is a sum total of all the plants, animals and microorganisms in an area along with non-living components such as climate, soil, river, deltas, etc. Red Data Book. Red Data Book is the source book which keeps a record of all the endangered animals and plants. Migration. Migration is the periodic movement of animals from one place to another. It is usually done for breeding and to escape harsh climate. Migration is common in birds and fishes. Thank you. Please do like, share, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to comment in the comment section below. Bye bye. Stay home and stay safe.